Boxing star Danny Garcia just enjoyed a big victory over Lamont Peterson. I'm here with Mr. Watson. First of all, what did you think of the fight?
I think it was a great fight. You know, different styles make different fights, and Lamont did two different things in the fight, and he adjusted, you know, his running around and making Danny miss early and, you know, try to tire him out, and it worked to a certain extent. I think he should start just a little earlier if he wanted to pull out the victory, but it was a great fight, and it was a close decision. You can't be mad either way.
You and your family are very, very close to a lot of the superstars, from Mayweather down. Adrian Broner wants Danny. Maidana wants Danny. What do you think about those fights for Danny, either Broner or Maidana?
I think they're all exciting fights. Danny has showed that he's not scared of anybody. You know, he'll fight anybody. And sometimes the media, you know, he can take a hit in the media for who he's fought. But you have to look at his history of fighters, and nobody fights a tough fight every time.
No one.
But Danny's pretty close, other than at Saka. Saka was a little, you know, undermatched, but I think those would be great matchups, and I think Danny would welcome the challenge. I mean, he's not afraid to fight anybody, and those are our fighters, so maybe one day it will happen when the time is right.
We are just 16 days away from the biggest fight in my lifetime, maybe your lifetime. I don't know how old you are, but Mayweather Pacquiao, how's your life looking for the next 15 days?
It's been crazy because most people just are getting ready for the Mayweather-Pacquiao fight. We've been having fights every week, so it's still like...
You have this one, Chubby Jr.
And then we got Anthony Durrell next week. But
in Chicago?
Yeah, every week leading up to the fight, there was a fight in a different city. So it's been a lot of freaking flyer miles, a lot of traveling. And it's getting more exciting, but we're still looking at three more fights before we even get to that one. So, you know, it's hard to get excited about something that's kind of four fights away for us, you know, four or five fights away. But definitely the biggest thing going on is the Super Bowl of boxing, and just can't wait.
As a person that's been in the ring with Mayweather before a fight, what would it mean to you to be in the ring seconds before he faces Manny?
I mean, you know,
it's cool.
It's definitely something that, you know, it's history, so of course you want to be a part of it, but, you know, we've been doing a lot of stuff behind the scenes now, so sometimes we aren't in the ring as much, but it's okay because that's just the way it goes, and people know the Watson brothers and Sam and, you know, Al, of course, and that's just what we do, and we just enjoy doing it.
So if you or your brother or your dad got in a fight, who would you want to walk you guys in? Who would you want to hold your belt?
Who would walk you?
Me? Okay, I'm down. I'll do it. At least take back reporting.
That'd be funny, yeah.
That would be fun, but get attention.
Yeah.
Another fighter you guys work with, and he's one of the nicest people, Leo Santa Cruz. Humble, works hard, fights anybody anywhere. Yeah. He's fighting May 2nd.
Yeah.
What do you think?
He's definitely getting that platform.
It's a Mexican holiday.
He's still building his you know, his resume. He's up and coming. People think stuff just happens overnight, and you think that just because he's been on all these cards, he's supposed to fight this guy, he's supposed to fight that guy. But, you know, it takes time to build a champion, and it takes time. I know everybody wants it now, but Leo's time is coming, and he's going to fight all the big fights that everybody wants. And I'm excited for him because he is the nicest guy in the world. But he turns into a monster in the ring, and you want to pull for guys like that because he's definitely one of the more humble champions that are around.
Personally, I prefer it that way than a guy that out of the ring talks all that, does all that, gets in the ring and
tanks. His words can't even express how good a guy Leo is. And, you know, fans are fans and media's media, but Leo's been the same guy, and he doesn't care who he fights, so it's never his decision. You know, like, he doesn't – they can put three guys up there, he'll fight them all, you know, in one night. But, you know, that's not the way it goes, and it's a business, so –
He's a fighter. His job is to fight. Yeah. He doesn't pick up opponent. He doesn't
exactly,
say.
Exactly, yeah. He can say who he wants, and he'll get who he wants eventually. So, you know, just be patient with Leo, and he's going to be a star for the long time.
My last question in this interview, two things actually. Mayweather Pacquiao, how do you see the fight unfolding?
Well, I'm definitely pulling for Floyd. He's a part of the team. He's a great fighter. He does a lot. He works hard. His defense is impeccable. You know, Manny Pacquiao is a great fighter also. So, you know, the thing is they have gloves on, so they have to decide it. I can't help either one of them, and I think that Floyd will be victorious in decision. I don't know about knocking him out or anything, but, you know, you never know. But I think Floyd will do enough to win the fight.
If all the fans want to follow you on Instagram, where do they go?
We on Follow me on B Watson, but it's with a zero, the number zero, BWATS0N, and my brother's MWATTY1, MYD1.
How will the Dodgers do this year?
Who cares?
The no, Matt Kemp is not there.
Nah, they'll be all right. They got a lot of veteran leaders in that clubhouse now, and you know they're not dumb. They know what they're doing. They brought in a different attitude towards winning and stuff like that.
They're spending money?
Yeah, they're spending money. They got some older guys that are a little more veteran, a little more, you know, calm. But, you know, Matt D. Gordon knows I'm a guy, so, you know, it is what
it is. If they recruited you, would you help them win?
I could help anybody win.
What would it take to get you on the Dodgers?
A contract.
That simple as that?
I come out of retirement right now, yeah.
All right, hopefully it happens. Hey, I'll be there every game if that happens. FaceReport.com and Malisic Back Reporting.